I'm Alan Hall, CEO and President of WeatherGuard Lightning Tech, here to discuss composite lightning protection. So what do we do for composite structures on aircraft and on wind turbines to protect them from lightning strikes? There are really four main lightning protection devices, schemes, approaches to protect composite structures from lightning damage. When I talk about composite structures, I mean carbon fiber and or fiberglass or Kevlar, so basically all your different kinds of fibers. Let's discuss number one, and probably the most used today, is expanded metal foil. So these are thin foils, typically somewhere between 2 and up to like 10 mils thick, that are punched and pulled, so they have diamond shapes in them. It allows them to be flexible and to contour to complex surfaces. These expandable metal foils come in all different varieties of metals, from aluminum to copper to, in some cases, bronze and other varieties, depending on what your needs are. But aluminum or copper are probably the two most prevalent ones, with bronze probably being third. So those expanded metal foils are applied to the carbon fiber or fiberglass surface. They conduct lightning energy away from the composite surface and thereby protect the composite structure. Key points about expanded metal foils are their effectiveness depends on how much paint or coatings are over top of them. So the thicker the paint, the less effective an expanded metal foil will be, and you may end up using a thicker metal foil. Sometimes when you're using normal layers of paint, 5, 8, 10 mils of paint, you can use thinner layers of expanded metal foil that tend to work a little bit better. But your results may vary, so I needed to check it. The second most common types of lightning protection material for composite structures are interwoven wire. Now, you don't see a lot of interwoven wire, you don't hear a lot about it, but interwoven wire is essentially this. They interweave in a carbon fiber ply, typically, sometimes in fiberglass, but mostly in carbon fiber. With the individual toes, they'll put small diameter wires, typically 4 mil diameter wires, with the carbon toes. Therefore, you get this this sort of a weave pattern that's built into the fabric. And the benefit of something like this is that it adds very little weight. So in an expanded foil case, you need adhesive to stick the expanded foil onto your composite structure. So it's not only the expanded foil weight, but the place, the extra weight of the adhesive to go along with it. With interwoven wire, the wire is part of the carbon fiber fabric or fiberglass ply. So the only additional weight really is the wire itself, which is extremely minimal. So there's a benefit to interwoven wires. Now, interwoven wires typically come with the wires being aluminum or phosphor bronze. You see phosphor bronze today. Those are the two types of wires. They're both pretty effective. They work best with thin coatings of paint over top, somewhere between 5, 8, 10 mils of paint is very typical for those types of structures. Interwoven wire does not like working on very thick layers of paint. Interwoven wire works by the effect of, as lightning current is conducted into a piece of carbon fiber or fiberglass, those little metal wires expand and basically explode out of the surface, open up an area for lightning to be a wider area for lightning to be attracted to, and conduct and let the lightning be conducted away across a wider area, thereby reducing the energy density that the lightning is on a piece of composite structure. So it basically reduces the damage by spreading out the energy, lowering the energy per unit area. The next one, and something that's a little more recent, is the conductive paints and coatings. There's always been conductive paints, like copper paint has been a very common thing in the past. More recently, there's been more silver-loaded paints and silver-loaded films, which are very, very conductive and have had really good test results, at least in the technologies that I have seen, one of them being the ultra-conductive film and ultra-conductive paint by Lord Corporation, which is now, I think, Sycamore. But that material does provide a decent level of lightning protection, but it is an additional layer, right? So you're actually going to apply something over your composite structure. So the last one, and probably the oldest technology, is plated fibers. So mostly nickel plating can be applied to carbon fiber or fiberglass. The fiberglass version was called Thor Strand. You occasionally see it in older papers discussing lightning protection, but you can also nickel plate carbon fiber. It is somewhat effective. Basically, you're adding conductivity to carbon fiber, which is sort of resistive. So you're giving lightning a place to go and travel on the nickel coating. And the nickel coating also tends to vaporize away. Again, very similar to interwoven wire, where you want to expand the area where lightning is attached to, basically lower the energy density down so that no particular spot on the composite structure is taking all the energy. It's a pretty effective way of going about it. But the plated fiber, you don't see it around as much, but you do see it occasionally. So when you run across it, you just know what that is. You know, with all this technology, one of the things that it's probably the most prevalent criteria or concern about each of these technologies is how to repair it and how to apply paint to it, or more importantly, how not to damage it while it's in service. So on an aluminum airplane, if you're going to strip the airplane and repaint it, that's pretty easy. There's all kinds of chemical strippers that can be used to remove the paint off of an aluminum airplane, even abrasives, okay? But on a piece of carbon fiber or a piece of fiberglass with a very thin metal foils or coatings, you got to be careful because you can abrade into those, and you really can't use solvents on composite airplanes so much. So a lot of times it's an abrasive technique, and you can sand into those foils and coatings and interwoven wires and damage them. So you have to be really careful around composite structures, no matter what the lightning protection system is, on how to take care of it, maintain it, so you don't damage it in service. So those are really the top four composite lightning protection schemes that are used today. If you're interested in lightning protection or have questions about lightning protection, check out our YouTube channel, which has a ton of informational videos on it, or visit our website, weatherguardaero.com.